Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to explain about graph traversal methods. Graph traversal is known as finding an element in the graph. Basically, there are two methods. First is breadth first search and next is depth first search. Breadth first search, it is also known as BFS. It is an algorithm for searching a tree. It starts at the tree root and explores all nodes to get the search element. Here this is an example. Here this is a tree with nodes A, B, C, D, E and F. In step 1, as it is the first node, A is the search element. In step 2, the search element is B because it is connected to A. Again B is connected with C, D, E. So now the search element is at the node C, again it goes to the element D and last it goes to the E. These are the connected nodes of the element B. The search ends at the node F because it is the last node in the tree. So this is about the breadth first search. Next is depth first search. It is an algorithm for traversing or searching a tree. Here the algorithm starts at the root node and explores as far as possible along each branch in the tree. It is also known as DFS. Here this is an example for depth first search. Here we can see the nodes A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. For these nodes, we have to write the adjacency nodes. Here the adjacency list is for A, B and D are the adjacent nodes. For B, C and F are the adjacent nodes. For C, E, G, H are the adjacent nodes. For G, E and H are the adjacent nodes. For E, B and F are the adjacent nodes. For F, A is the adjacent node. For D, F is the adjacent node. And for H, A is the adjacent node. According to the directions in the graph, we take the adjacent nodes. So this is about the depth first search. Applications of breadth first search. BFS is useful in connectivity problems and for finding the shortest path. Next is applications of depth first search. DFS is useful in cycle detection and connectivity testing. And DFS requires less memory when compared to BFS and it is faster than BFS. So this is about graph traversal methods. Thank you.